sword or magic, but why not to have them both? He was born as a very sickly child, so when the time has come to serve their liquor, that was a hard times for you. Fellow soldiers laughed on you, and each training day was a hell. And so, you started to search other ways, opened magic for yourself, for which you, suddenly, got a decent talent. After all, you grew up in a strong warrior, but even after you pumped up some muscles, you had never forget about your second friend. You always have them both, might and magic, sword and a fireball, being a skilled warrior and a talented wizard in one person. Your enemies should be afraid of you, as they will never sure what to expect from your next hit. Wandering the Tamriel, Road of Adventures brought you to cold snowy land. And so, here you are, Sparkstriker in Skyrim. Welcome to the best Skyrim build series. Who is the Sparkstriker? It is a spell sword build for those who don't want to choose between might and magic, to not make two separate walkthroughs, but still being able to build a strong character who will be a capable combatant and interesting to play at the same time. In that case, here we go. Sparkstriker is a class who uses one-handed weapons and distraction magic to be able to overcome any type of enemies, warriors, mages, undead, and tough bosses. Many people often end with very weak characters when building a spell sword because of spreading perk points too much without a good results in power in the end. But don't worry, with Ordinator, Apocalypse and understanding of synergy of perks and spells, you will not repeat same mistakes. So, let's begin. Race, Redguard. Race choice is very simple. As a spell sword, you will be relying a lot on bursts of damage coming out from combined physical and magical damage, and on the other side, you will have not so much magicka as a pure mage. Redguard's Dust Storm will be a great booster to increase your damage even more and to make your mana cost lower at the same time, shining exactly in two most important scenes for spell sword. Nomadic Heritage is just a good utility passive for exploration, saving your time in travels, and Tenacity is an additional safe passive to boost your regenerations when you are at low health. This is also important, as without shield and full arsenal of spells that pure mages have, you still could be vulnerable to damage sometimes. This will help you to recover faster. Attributes. This depends on how aggressive you are usually playing, but anyway, I would not recommend to put less than 40% of attributes into health. For most balanced option, invest like 50% of attributes in health and 25% respectively to both magicka and stamina. You will not need more, as spell sword is not relying on master spells too much and his stamina regeneration is also very high. Standing Stones. First of all, a little notification. Starting from this build, you should use Andromeda mod instead of Aurora for Standing Stones, if you want to follow my builds properly. It is a new Standing Stones mod from the same author, so don't worry, it is just more dynamic and interesting. In early game, the best option is Apprentice Stone. Main reason here is that it makes all novice spells free to cast and makes all other spells 15% cheaper to cast, which will be very useful at low levels. Apprentice Ultimate spell is also a great saving ability, but as usual, I will not spoiler it. The optional stone for early game is Lower Stone, as with Andromeda mod, it gives you random enchanted items from time to time, which will be very helpful as enchanting is one of your core skills and you will need to raise it ASAP, but still, Apprentice is much better option. For mid and late game, pick up either Warrior or Mage Stone, depending on your playstyle, but I personally choosing Warrior Stone, as the biggest amount of our damage will still come through physical damage. Also, Warrior Stone empowers exactly the power attacks, which will be our main source of physical damage. Now, straight to the most interesting part, the perks. Your first core skill is enchanting, and especially interesting here, it is Spellscribe Branch. Now you are also starting to see why I recommended exactly the Warrior Stone, which empowers power attacks. For Spark Striker, maxing your enchanting and alteration skills is your top priority, because exactly these two skills are core and unique part of the build. In enchanting, start from basic perk and take the right branch completely. It allows you to recharge your weapon passively, which is very useful. Next perk increases enchantment's damage when delivered by, guess what, power attack. Spellscribe is one of the key perks which allows you to, let's say, remember damaging spell and charge weapon with it, launching it for free when you are power attacking. Ability cooldown depends on your enchanting skill, and at max skill level it is almost zero, meaning almost endless free spells from power attacks. Might and Magic is a simple power booster for spell sword, increasing your magic and physical damage while you have weapon in right hand and respectively spell in left. Power Echoes is also making Spellscribe ability to be activated one more time before going on cooldown, which is especially helpful for high damage bursts. In addition, simply take whole middle branch, the main one in enchanting, that is actually about empowering enchantments themselves. It makes enchantments stronger, last longer, give you ability to make 2 or even 3 enchantments on one item, and so on. In alteration, we need 2 middle branches. Right middle branch is second core for spell sword unique playstyle. Learn it completely. It is all about synergy between spells and sword. The first perk in this branch increases your attack damage when you're casting a spell with your left hand. Second perk decreases armor of nearby enemies when you're casting once again a spell with your left hand. The last perk is decreasing enemies' magic resistances when you're attacking with your right hand weapon. The left middle branch is all about self buffs, which is also pretty important as spell sword lacks tankiness, and so these bonuses will be very useful. You can increase one of your attributes, obviously hit points, increase your 2 resistances, pick up of course any bio taste, but I would recommend frost and shock resistances bonus to have some additional defense against enemy spells draining your magicka and stamina respectively. And the last perk is just a great passive debuff that prevents enemies around you from regenerating magicka and stamina. Third main skill, one-handed, obviously. Important note, start to learn weapon type specialized perks, one of 3 middle branches for axes, maces or swords, only after you will master core branches from alteration, enchanting and of course all other perks from one-handed. In one-handed, everything is pretty clear. Learn all the perks from boss left branches besides Rogue's Parry, as it is designed for empty left hand. Learn Furious Strength for stamina-based damage boost, Overrun for greatly increased sprinting power attack, Disciplined Fighter for decreasing stamina cost for power attacks, and of course Thundering Blow and Aftershock for empowering your all power attacks even more. Choice of weapon specialization is completely up to you. I'm personally a sword fan, but once again it is completely a matter of taste. Secondary skills, Destruction. Yes, you see it right, you have to spend only 3 perk points in destruction. 2 points for main perk to scale spell's damage and 1 more for destruction dual casting. Obviously, we will not be dual casting in combat at all, but Spellscribe perk requires spell you will remember for your power attacks to be exactly dual casted, so it is just a technical perk. Note, there is one optional twist then you can or cannot make in the end of the build to spend like 5 or 6 more perk points into destruction, but I will tell about it a bit later. Light armor. Here everything is simple once again. You should take literally all possible perks here, besides of course the unarmed combat perks. As a spell sword, you don't have great defensive abilities from shields or master level spells, as you are aggressive class, and so parameters like stamina regeneration, dodge, speed and additional damage boosters are much more important. And light armor in Ordinator can give you all that easily. Decrease damage when fighting multiple enemies, increase movement speed, dodging attacks once per 5 seconds when jumping and much more. Everything to improve your survival abilities through making you move, regenerate and kill faster. Restoration. This is where you can make some little build twist and spend a few perk points here for additional survival abilities and enemy debuffing, or spend them into destruction skill. My personal choice is to spend them here exactly, because like 5 or 6 perk points in destruction will of course give you some damage bonus, but not so noticeable as your spell damage is not continuous, while same perks in restoration will greatly increase your tenacity and give additional counters against enemies. Must have perks here: Restoration Mastery, obviously, Edgewalker for bonus healing, Respite to restore your stamina as well, and Descending Light to give you bonus to magic regeneration in combat. Next two perks are about wards. Free first ward in combat, spell absorbing when using a ward, but most important is anti-magic field that silences enemies when you're casting a ward close to them. That's basically and literally a simple mage counter. Second feature, Warrior's Flame, is a passive spell that randomly jumps in on you or enemies. Enemies lose magicka and stamina, and you regenerate in health, magicka and stamina. And in addition, Warrior's Flame on enemy decreases this enemy's armor and magic resistance, which gives amazing synergy with Alteration spell sword last perk, which is also decreasing it. Now a few words about enchantments and spells. This part is of course just my recommendation. You guys may change it as you like, but this may be a good base and direction in which you can move here. First of all, enchantments. Do not underestimate them, as enchanting is your main skill and your enchantments can power up you drastically. As for ultimate enchanting talent, which allows to place 3 enchantments on one item at once, I chosen sword and added 3 drains, health, magic and stamina, for additional damage and sustain at the same time. Helmet. Decrease mana cost for destruction and restoration. Gauntlets. Absorb stamina and bonus to one-handed damage. Boots. Speed bonus and bonus to one-handed damage. Armor. Death ward and little chance to restore health, stamina and magicka each second. Ring. Magic resistance and bonus to one-handed damage. Amulet. The same. As you can see, structure is next. Empower one-handed damage by all chances possible, and everything the rest is about survival and tenacity. Spells. Okata Recital Structure. Okata Recital is alteration spell that allows you to remember 3 self-buff spells to cast them automatically when you enter in combat. First spell. Obviously a flash spell. Second spell. Apocalypse Spell Pack. Healing Blossom. Great healing spell that is working with delay, which is also great knowing it is casted in beginning of combat. Third spell. Apocalypse Spell Pack. 3 rings. A great HP buff that is gradually fading off during the next 30 seconds. Its main goal is to prevent you from being one-shotted by some kind of unexpected attack when combat starts. Additional restoration spells. Obviously wards to fight against strong mages. Fast healing for fast healing. King's Heart, Apocalypse Spell Pack, restoration. Spark of Light that is following you, healing you and increasing your skills. Destruction spells. Fireball, one of the great choices for Spellscribe, as it has area of effect damage. Forbidden Sun, very powerful area of effect spell, but is also decreasing enemies' fire resistance. It is very long to cast, so it is great spell to initiate combat when you see your enemies and decrease their magic fire resistance straight for your upcoming fireballs. Howling Blast, great against big groups of melee enemies to damage them and rapidly drain their stamina, making them helpless. Scorching Hands, a very short range but very powerful fire spell. Slee Storm, great ice spell that fires rapid barrage of icicles at long range. What do we receive in the end? We have a balanced mix of warrior and mage, who has insanely high weapon damage, which is also empowered by 3 elemental bonus damage, giving him insane damage bursts, one-shotting most of regular enemies. With his left hand, he can easily switch between offensive and defensive magic to adapt to any encounter, whether it be a group of warriors, mages or any other monsters, as he has wide enough spell arsenal for that. He also has enough survival abilities, thanks to ridiculous strength of enchantments and once again decent protective spells arsenal. Well, fine, you can say. What about the bosses? No problems. Let's pay, as usual, a friendly visit to Red Eagle, which is, by the way, has level 105,000 HP, empowered by Revenge of the Enemies mod. As you can see, we debuffed him with Forbidden Sun for first power attack and its fireball, which in total hit him for almost 40% of its health, which is about 2000 damage by the way. Next two power attacks finished him. Assault was so fast that he and his guardians only started to charge on me. 5000 damage in 3 hits. I hope you guys enjoyed this build. Thank you for watching and wish you happy times playing it. Be sure to enable channel notifications and join our Discord to always stay in touch. Scimitar Gaming here, signing out.